रिकॉर्डिंग में स्टार्ट होनी।
हाँ सर, थैंक यू सर।
ओके, सो लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड द बीसीडी एडर। सो बिफोर यू स्टार्ट द बीसीडी एडर, लेट्स टेल यू दैट व्हाट इज द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ दिस बीसीडी एडर। नाउ एवरीबॉडी हैव द साइंटिफिक कैलकुलेटर, ओके, and this is a digital calculator, means using some digital logics, the using some digital coding logic, digital data, the input as well as the output is represented in the screen. Now say you want to add this number, khub kothin ekta addition dilam, parbe keu? What is the result?
20.
Very good. So this is decimal addition. 12 plus 8 equal to 20. Now, in case of digital device, this data is converted to the digital logic. Okay. So how the addition is done actually? Okay. How to convert this BCD number 12? Okay. So forget about this one. Forget about this. Let's take this one. Now what is the result? 10.
Okay.
What is the representation of 2 in digital or in okay, because the representation of 2 in digital BCD or binary both are same. So what is the representation of 8 in 4 digit in 2 in 4 digit?
0010.
Sir, 1000 sir.
Yeah, beta 0010.
Sir, 8 is sir, 8 is sir.
8 a very good. 8 a 1 0 0 0. Okay. Now add them. 0 plus 0 equal to 0 1 0 1 plus 0 equal to 1. So obviously this is equal to 10. Okay, but a layman understand this is equal to 10 unless you don't know the how to convert the binary to decimal.
No.
So is it the BCD number? Obviously no. Because what is the representation of 10 in BCD? 10 in BCD means 0, 0, 0, 1, and for 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So this is actually the BCD representation of 10. But when you do the simple binary addition like this one, we never get this one. We never get this one. Okay. So this is called the BCD addition. Means after the addition, the result should be in the BCD form, not in the binary form. Okay, so that means we need to know the BCD addition also. Understand what is the difference between binary addition and BCD addition? Binary addition results in binary number. The result is the summation process is also in the binary form. But this is the main difference in the binary form, because unless we know the conversion procedure, you are not able to understand what is the decimal equivalent, because everybody, the whole world is run by the decimal number system. So this, unless we know the conversion procedure, we don't know the decimal equivalent of this one, that this is equal to 10. But in the BCD form, that the display device or any other device can be easily represented that one. So how to implement the BCD adder? So for this one, first you need to know the conversion and the coding. Here you see, this is one by decimal number 12. Now, when the 12 is converted to the binary, it's become 1100. Okay, because 2 is there, 2 base is there. This is called the base of the radix point. So that means equal to binary number. So this is the binary number, and this is called the conversion. This process is called the conversion because you need to know some formula to convert the number to the binary. Okay, and this is the BCD representation of the 12. 1. And this is equal to 2. So this is equal to 1 and this is equal to 2. So that means this is the BCD representation of the 12, and this is called the coding. Okay, so coding means it's not actually converted. Coding means something is modified with this number and it is coded in this form. The value is remain same here. The value is obviously remain same here also, but this is not generally understand the conversion unless you know the conversion rule. But from the coding, one can easily understand what is the value of this one. This is the same thing. This 1 and 2 digit is remain same. This 1 digit and the 2nd digit is remain same, and it is actually represented in the defined form. So this is called the coding. So this is the difference between conversion and coding. BCD actually not convert the number. BCD actually coded the number in the binary form. So come to this one, BCD adder. So design a circuit that calculate the arithmetic addition of the two decimal digit 9 and 3. So 9 and 3, if we add the 9 and 3, the summation is 2 and the output carry is 1. So the result is 1 to 12. Okay. Here you see. In case of the BCD adder, maximum sum is how much? Okay. First of all, what is the BCD? What is the BCD?
So binary coded decimal.
Binary coded decimal. So what is the maximum number used in the decimal number system? Maximum symbol or the maximum number used to represent the number in the decimal number system?
9.
0 to 9. Maximum actai hoy. So 9. So 9 is the maximum digit used in the decimal number system to represent this number. Okay, so if you are able to understand the 9 is the maximum digit to represent the decimal number, then you can tell me that what is the maximum value of the sum? Maximum sum is how much? Maximum sum is 9 + 9 + 1. So why this 1 is there? Because this is the carry generated in the previous steps. It may happen that carry may be generated in the previous step. So these two maximum number 9 + 9 + 1, so 19 is the maximum digit in the BCD adder. Ebar dekho jara bujhte parni tara ki kore add korche eta dekho. Suppose I take one number 1 2 3, sorry, any number. When you want to add this to this three number, how to add this number? First we need to add. Ki kore korbo bolo?
361 ke proteme korte hobe, tar pore 172.
Okay, so here you see that with respect to the computer, they are not actually add this three number, because in the computer only one device is there, which is called the full adder, and this full adder add three bits at a time. And among the three bit, one should be the carry generated in the previous steps. That's why how they add, they actually add this 3 and 6 together first. With the result, they actually add the 1. In this way, the addition procedure done inside the computer. Every time 2 digit can be added at a time. After this, any other digit added. So if there is thousands of number, so these thousands of number is not added simultaneously, all are added 2 by 2. First two, then with the result the second, means the third, after the result the fourth, after the result the five, like this one. So stage by stage, this is called the stage addition. So stage by stage additions are there. So that's why if say 5 numbers are there, and don't think that 5 nines are present, so the maximum sum may be 9 + 9 = 45. It's a wrong concept. So at a particular time, only 2 digit can be added. Okay. And 1 can be added together. So this 1 is not the number. This 1 is the carry generated in the previous stage. Okay. So like this one, 6 + 3, this is equal to 9. Then 7, 10. Oh, to kono carry asche na. Oh, 10 carry asche. So 0 and 1 carry will be there. Now check the last digit. Last, how to add? First, we need to add 3, 8. 3 + 4 = 4, 4 + 8 = 12, 12 + 5 = 17. So in this way, stage by stage additions are there. So that means at a particular time, the maximum sum can be 9 + 9, because 9 is the maximum number. So 9 + 9 + carry generated in the previous stage. Carry may be, what is the maximum value of the carry? In case of BCD, it is always 1. Okay, because BCD to eram hoy na je ami ekhane 23 pelam, so 2 will be the carry. So that happened in case of digital number. So in case of binary, the carry is always 1. Okay, so that means the maximum sum can be 9 + 9 + 1 = 19. So these are the two maximum digit, that is the carry from the previous digits. Now come to this one. Oh, but this is a very concepts are required to understand this BCD adder. Come to this one. So this is the BCD adder, sum up to 9. Now this is the number. these are the number, this one is the carry, this is the sums. Four sums, summations are there, this is the carry. Now if the number is up to nine, if the number is up to nine, then no modification, this is not the carry, this is the correction bit. This is the correction bit. No corrections are needed, because if the number is up to nine, then whatever is the binary, same as the BCD. You see, 90 means what? 0 means 0, 0, 0, 0. You see, S3 equal to 0, S2 equal to 0, S1 equal to 0, S0 equal to 0. So 0 represent in binary or in BCD, both are same. Similarly, for the 5 also, what is the representation of 5 in binary? 5 in binary is 0, 1, 0, 1. So this is the representation of 5 in binary, same as the BCD. Okay. No modification, no corrections are needed. Up to 9, no modification, corrections are needed. But if the summation is more than 9, then some correction is required, like this one. If it is 10, okay, how to represent 10? One correction bit should be there, and the remaining is 0000, because 10 is there. Similarly, say 16. So in case of 16, how to represent 16? So one correction bit should be there, means we need to correct it, and rest of the 6 is display here, 0, 1, 1, 0. So that means up to 19, because 19 is the maximum summation result. So up to 19, from 10 to 19, the corrections are required. Why the corrections are required? Because the binary representation of the 10 is not same as the BCD representation. Binary representation of 10 is how much? 1, 0, 1, 0. This is the binary representation of 10. But BCD representation of 10 is not same. BCD representation of 10 is 0001 0000, means 1 is represented in another form, means another 4 digit. 0 is represented using another 4 digit. So this is the difference between binary representation and BCD representation. Up to 9, no problem, but from 10 to 19, we need to correct the display. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that means you now understand why the correction is required, because the correction is required because the representation is not same in binary as well as in the BCD from the number 10 to 19. Okay. And why 19? Short question. Why 19? Because 19 is the maximum number in case of a adder. বাইনারি কোডে ডেসিমাল নাম্বার, সো ইন কেস অফ ডেসিমাল নাম্বার দ্য ম্যাক্সিমাম নাম্বার ইজ 9, দ্য ম্যাক্সিমাম সিম্বল হুইচ ইজ ইউজ টু রিপ্রেজেন্ট দ্য ডেসিমাল ডিজিট ইজ 9. অ্যান্ড what is the maximum sum? So it may be, as we know, that 2 bits at a time with the carry. So 2 bit means 2 maximum digit, 9 and 9, and another carry. Carry is always 1. So carry is coming from the previous stage. So carry is 1. So 9 plus 9 plus 1, 19. So that's why 19 is the maximum sum in case of a BCD adder.
Okay, sir.
And correction is required from the number 10 to 19. And if we are before 10, means 0 to 9, no correction is required because the representation is same for the BCD and binary. So BCD adder sum 10 to 19, because this 10 to 19 is the main problematic thing. If the summation is up,
এটা
পড়লে এটা
এর আগের স্লাইডটা যেটা এর আগের স্লাইডটা স্যার হ্যাঁ স্যার এই যে সামটা পড়লেন স্যার এখানে স্যার ওই ফার্স্টে ওখানে 9 মানে 1 টা ওখানে অ্যাড হলো না কেন
কোনটা বল এইখানে
3 + 6 9 + এখানে 1 টা স্যার অ্যাড হলো না কেন
এখানে 1 তো এখানে তো এটা দিস ইজ দা ইনিশিয়াল স্টেজে দেয়ার ইজ নো ক্যারি. This is the start of the summation procedure. So there is no carry from the previous stage. So 6 plus 3 plus 9. Then in this stage, if there is any carry, that carry goes to there. And fortunately, there is no carry. So 0 is be there. Initially, carry thakena ami kono din jokhon amra joke shikhi tokhon ki hate niye kichu shikhi? Obviously, no. So in the initial stage of addition, there is no carry. After the first stage of addition, this is the stage of addition. After the stage of addition, then if there is any carry generated, that carry will go to the next stage. Like this one. So initially the carry is always there, 0. That's why when you design the parallel adder, you see the first full adder, the carry is connected to the ground. Okay. So now if the sum result is 10 to 19, then you see this is the binary summation and this is the result of the BCD adder sum. So BCD adder sum, jeta tumra ektu age dekhlo, so from 10 to 19, the corrections are required because the representation is not same. And 10 means one correction bit and 0000. Similarly, 15 means how much? 15 means one correction bit and 50101, like this one. Similarly, 19 means one correction bit and 1001. So this is equal to 9 or the zero position digit and one position digit, and this is the 10 position digit. Come to the binary summation. Binary summation, you see, if it is 10, then representation of 10 is 1010. Okay, so this is then only the binary summation result. Here you see for 16, it's equal to 10000. Okay, this is a representation is binary. Similarly, for 19, it's equal to 16. The first one is 16, then 3. 16 plus 3 equal to 19. So this is the binary, this is the BCD summation result, and this is the binary summation result. This is just a representation. If the summation result is from 10 to 19, then how we represent it in the BCD form, showing in the left side table, and how we showing the result in the binary form is showing in the right side table. So just check these two tables, and if you have any problem to understand this one, ask me. This is just a representation.
BCD summer khetre sir correction ta dorkar keno mane correction ta mane 0001 neki?
No, correction means some correction is required to represent the number, because how to represent 10 in binary? 1010. Okay, so 1010, is it binary form? Is it BCD form? Obviously no. This is actually the conversion of the number from 10 to 1010. But if you want to represent 10 in BCD form, then how to represent 10? 0001 0000. So that means the representations are different in these two form. One is the BCD and is the binary. So from 10 to 19, the representations are totally different. That's why some correction is required to change the number, change the representation. Okay. Now let's delete all these things. So here you see, let's check this one. This row is exactly same as this row. Here you see, this is equal to 10000. Okay, in this BCD representation, this is equal to 10000. And you see this one, this is also 10000. See, both the rows are same or not? Same. Come to this one, these two rows are also same. So you check the representation in the BCD as well as in the binary, both the rows are exactly same. This is equal to 10001 in BCD, same as the binary. Come to this one, same. This one is also same. এবার দেখো এইটা কারো বুঝতে অসুবিধা হচ্ছে না যে দিস রোজ আর এক্স্যাক্টলি সেম অ্যাজ হেয়ার দ্য নেক্সট রোজ ইজ সেম হেয়ার সেম হেয়ার সেম হেয়ার সো দিস অল আর সেম ইন বাইনারি অ্যাজ ওয়েল অ্যাজ ইন দ্য বিসিডি ওকে সো উই হ্যাভ টু স্কিপ দিস সিক্স রো হাউ মেনি রোজ আর দেয়ার 1 2 3 4 5 6 So this six row must be skipped. Otherwise, if it is skipped, if you are able to skip these six rows, then the representation of BCD is same as the representation in binary. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So that's why we need to add the result with plus six just to skip this six row. So that's why the plus six is written here. It means if we just skip this six row by adding the number six, then the representation is binary, same as the representation is BCD. Okay, like this one. So algorithm for BCD adder, if the sum is up to 9, use the regular adder. Okay, because if the sum is up to 9, whatever is BC, same as the binary. No corrections are required. If the sum is more than 9, okay, up to 19, obviously. If the sum is more than 9, then some corrections are required. Then how to correct this one? We need to add 6 with the result to make it BCD. Why add 6? Because we actually want to skip 6 rows. How to add 6 rows? This rows is nothing but a number. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, like this one. So if we add extra 6 with the number, then this thing can be removed. Then the representation is remain same. So when the result is greater than 9, then binary sum is this one. So here you see number 10 to 19 is showing here. Corrections is there. And every time we need to correct the number because the representations are not same. We need to add extra 6 with this one. So corrections are required. C out, this is the C out. So this is actually representation is binary. So 10 binary in 1010. Similarly, 1 means 101, 11 means 1011, 12 means this one, 13 this one, 16 this one, up to 19 is this one. Okay. So this is a C out. These are the summation result. Here it's showing Z. Generally, summation results are showing by S. So Z0, Z1, Z2, Z3, this is the ultimately C out of the summation result. And in all this case, when the result is more than 9, the corrections are required. Okay, we need to find out the correction expression because, as I mentioned, correction is required. But what is the correction and how to implement this correction in the digital form? So that means first we need to form the expression of the correction, then can we easily implement this one. This is the truth table. So from the truth table, how to find out the expression? You know the procedure using the K-map. So using the K-map only, we can find out the procedure for representing the number. Okay, and here how many variables are there? How many variables are there?
Four variables. And three out. I mean five, sir, total.
Five variables. Ki bole arba bol? Four and?
I mean, chatte variables. Z1, Z0, Z2, Z3, C out. Ekta,
five. Very good, very good. Four and C out to sunte mani. So total five variables are there. Z0, Z1, Z2, Z3, C out. So total five variables are there. So using these five variables, we need to do some K-map to find out the expression of the correction. And here you see that correction is, acha, five variables means how many cells should be there in the K-map?
32.
Five. Very good. So five variables are there, okay. Five variable mean 2 to the power 5. 2 to the power 5 is how much? 32. So 32 cells should be there in the K-map. So this is the structure of the five variable K-map. This one is the structure of the five variable K-map. Okay, this is the structure. So here you see total 32 cells are there. This is represented C out, Z3 and Z2. So three variables means starting from 0000 to 111, but it is in the gray form. Okay, so here you see 0000001. After 001010 is not there. Why? Because the label of the K-map should be in the gray form. Okay, so this is the gray of 0, this is the gray of 111. Okay, and this is the z0 z1 z0. This is equal to simple 00011110. This is in gray form, this is also in gray form. Structure bujhecho shobai? The structure of five variable K-map, only the structure. Understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then you need to map the expression of correction here. So check the correction column. Correction is 1 in 10, 1 in 11, 1 in 12, up to 19, it is 1. So fill it up. This is equal to how much? Who can tell me the value of this particular cell?
12, sir.
Very good, perfect. So this is equal to 12. Tui bolbi na ebar, onno koi bolbe. What is the meaning of this particular cell? This one. Bolo, see how is the MSB?
13, sir.
13, very good. So this is equal to 12, this is equal to 13, this is equal to how much? 14. This is equal to this is 15, this is equal to 14. What is the meaning of that particular cell?
11 sir.
Very good, perfect. Okay. Now let's check what is the meaning of this cell. Bato, how much?
16.
Very good. Confident. 16. This is equal to 10000. So 10000 means 16. This is equal to how much?
19.
Very good. 19. Okay. Acha. Then this is equal to how much?
20.
Very good. Perfect. Now you see some cells are left here. Some cell left blank. Why the cells are left blank? Why this one is left blank? Left blank, left blank. Why nothing is there? Left blank is filled up by zero. Why it is zero? What is the value of the cell? Why some, you see some of the cells, very good, some of the cells are left blank, some of the cells are filled up by don't cross, don't care condition. So why this one is left? Because the meaning of the cell is 0, this is equal to 1, this is equal to 3, this is equal to 2. So 0 to 9, no collections are needed. So that's why they are filled up by 0 or nothing, blank, left blank. And some things are filled up by don't care condition. First of all, what is the meaning of that cell? What is the meaning of the cell? Jeta mark kora ache, what is the meaning of that cell? What is the mean term of this cell?
Don't care
is the value of the cell. What is the meaning? 20, what is the mean term?
24, sir.
24. Very good. This is equal to 24. Okay. Very good. Now, what is the meaning of the cell? Second one, this one. Okay, what is the meaning of that cell?
So 19.
Bull. Hello, brother. Oh, one minute. So nice. you people practice how to without taking up the help of any calculator or any pen paper, how to find out the binary equivalent up to five variables.
So what is the 23 hobe, sir?
23 likhe jimi dekh. Okay. And why the cells are filled up by don't care condition? The answer is that here we are using up to 19. Okay. Here we are using up to 19. And in case of five variable, the number starting from 0 to 31, total 32, so that means 0 to 31, total 32 numbers are used. But we are using up to 19, so that means 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 5, 6, 7, 8, 29, 30, 31. So these are the cells must be filled up by don't care condition, because in this procedure we are not using that one. So that's why they are filled up by don't care condition.
Yes, sir.
So this is actually the mapping of the correction to the K-map. Mapping is done. Then we need to create the group. And here, so many interesting things are there. This is not an ordinary four-variable K-map structure. This is a five-variable K-map structure. So how? Let's see how to find out the group. First, we can make a bigger group like this one. Total 8 cells are there. All the 8 cells filled up by 1 or the don't care condition. So don't care may be 1, 0. So here you take this don't care condition as 1. So that means this is a our bigger group. 8 members are there. And what is the meaning of the group?
See out.
This is equal to see out. Okay, very good. That is equal to see out, because you see, except the see out is one here. The see out is the first digit. See out is one here, one here, one here. So see out is not changing. All the other variables are changing here also. Z1, Z0 is also changing. Z3, Z2 is also changing. Only the C out is remain constant, all the cells. So it's nothing but the C out. Okay. Come to this one. This is our another group contain 8 members. Oh, sorry. This is 16 members are there. So here 16 members, bigger group. then a little bit smaller group contain 8 members. And what is the meaning of this group? Just check which quantities are remain unchanged up to these 8 members. And you see that this Z3 and here Z1 is not changing. So the meaning of the group is Z3, Z1. So these two ones are left, okay, because no other groups already formed using these two ones. Here all these left means the below 4-1 is already inserted in the first group. These 4-1s is also inserted in the group, but these two things are left. We have to make a group to means to cater this particular 2-1s. Here you see this is our third group, and here the main important things are there. You see these groups, ever you create the group like this one, these are not adjacent cells. How to create that group? Eram kore kono din group form korecho without the adjacent rows?
No, sir.
But we can form this group because we have never done the K map for 5 variables before. Okay, this is the first time we are doing the K map for the 5 variable. And as I mentioned that due to this problem, the K map cannot be formulated in the computer program. So many artificial intelligence are required to form the groups. Here, this is our smaller group. We may create the group like this one, but that will generate the 4 variables. But if we create the group like this one, which is showing by the yellow lines, then you see the expression is simple. If you form the group using the yellow one, then the expression is very simple, Z3, Z2. How it is become Z3, Z2 is important. Just check the group, check this column and this 4 row, Z1, Z0 is all changing, so delete it. And here you see the Z3 and Z2 is not changing. Here it is also not changing, here it is also not changing, both are 1-1. So that means this is equal to Z3, Z2. So the meaning of the group can be easily understand, but how to form the group? Here you see, as I mentioned, the K-map is a folding structure. That's why this is our line. Okay. So this is our division line. These are the adjacent cell, isn't?
Yes.
Isn't? Sir. These are the adjacent cell similarly. These are the adjacent, these are the adjacent. Now, this one is also adjacent to this one. These two cells are adjacent to each other. This is a folding structure, so if you just fold these things from the behind, from the between, then these three fall very near to each other, overlap each other, so we can say these two groups are these two groups are adjacent group. Similarly, these two groups are the adjacent group, obviously, like this one. But what is the definition of proper adjacent group? This is sometimes I use the local term that this is a folding structure. If the groups are side by side, then they may call the adjacent group. But these are all local language. What is the scientific definition of the adjacent group? The proper definition of the adjacent group is that just check any two cells. Suppose this one and this one. Is that they are adjacent or not?
Yes, sir.
How to understand? Based on which correct definition they are saying adjacent? The correct definition is that check the variable here. Here, check the variable Cout equal to 0, Z3 equal to 0, Z2 equal to 0, Z1 equal to 0, Z0 equal to 0. Okay. And check this one here Cout, Z3, Z2 all are 0, 0, 0, and Z1, Z0 is 0, 1. So that means between the group, if only one variable is changing, then they are called adjacent. Between any two cells, if only one variables are changed, only one variable is changing, then these two cells are called adjacent. The placement of the cell may be anywhere. Suppose one is here, another is maybe here. Just check these two. If only one variable is changing between these two cells, you definitely call it the adjacent. So this is the proper definition of the adjacent cells. Between the cells, if only one variables are changing, then it is called adjacent. So just check this one. Here you see this row and this row. You see one variable is changing only. So we may call it these are adjacent row, not the cells, adjacent row. And as all are filled by one, so this is become an adjacent and we can create a group like this.
Yes, sir.
So this is our third group, Z3, Z2. So the correction expression is Cout plus Z3, Z1 plus Z3, Z2. And based on the BCD, based on this correction, we just take this one. Simply 4-bit parallel adder is used to add the BCD number, but some correction is also required to represent this one. And here you see, what is the meaning of this one? This is the main important. So today I just take 2 to 3 minutes extra to understand this one, because eta jodi ami na kori tumra bujhte parben na. What is the meaning of this particular thing? Here you see parallel adder, 4-bit parallel adder means 2 4-bit numbers are added. Here it is very easy to understand that these are the first number, this is the second number, they are actually added together, and the result should be in the BCD form, because this is the BCD adder. So result should be in the BCD form. That's why 2 4-bit adders are required here. One, this is one, this is a two. And in the next stage, as I mentioned, if the result is less than 9, no corrections are required. If the result is more than 9, then corrections are required. What is the correction? Correction ta ki?
Plus 6.
Very good. So 6 should be added with the number, with the result, if the summation result is more than 9. So here you see, this is the place for the second digit. Okay, first digit is just the short circuited to the output of this first adder to the second adder. This is the input. This is the input of the second adder, and this is the output of the first adder. So first adder output is directly connected to the second adder input. Obviously, this is the second digit. So second digit is like this one, 0, 0, and in between the correction is connected. Okay, so here you see that if the correction is 1, 1, then what is the value? What is the meaning of this number?
6.
Very good. So I'm going to clear for this. So if the correction is 1, 1, then these are two short circuited. So 1, 1 should be connected here. And now you see it is become 6. If the correction is 0, then that is equal to 0. That is equal to 0. What is the meaning of the number?
0.
0. So if the number, if the correction is, if no corrections are required, then 0 will be added to the number. That means the number, the first summation result is remain unchanged. But if some correction is required, then this correction bit become 1, and in that time it's become 6. So if the correction is required, 6 will be added to the number to produce the ultimately summation result. So let's check this one. This is actually the BCD adder circuit. We will not show it here, we'll show it in the circuit maker software. And here, just for your understanding, this is the first stage adder. 7483 is the 4-bit parallel adder, which is readily available in the circuit maker software. So this is our first stage adder, this is our second stage adder, and this is actually the correction result. According to the KMAP we have done, the correction result is from here. This is the correction bit, and this correction bit is connected here. Okay, because you see this is equal to the B2 and B1 is short circuited. That means it is generating the 6. Okay, ekhan theke na, ekhan theke. Cout ta hobe na. Now let's check the operation in the circuit maker software. And this is actually the output. Let's check this one. So in case of circuit maker software, digital class, important circuit, BCD adder, BCD adder LED. Oh, this is actually the BCD adder LED. 1 minute, just okay, here you see that. Tell me one number, one BCD number. Anybody tell me one BCD number. Single digit BCD number.
8. 8.
Very good. So I give 8. 1 0 0 0 8. Another one, please tell me another BCD number.
6.
6. 1 0 1 1 0. This is 6. 6 plus 8 is how much?
14.
Now check this result. This is equal to what? This is equal to, this is the first set of BCD number, this is the second set of BCD number, because as 19 is the maximum number, so that means this is equal to 1. The rest of the things are 0 here. Okay, so first is equal to 1, first this is equal to 1, and this is equal to how much?
Sir, apnar pointer ta bujhte pachhi na kothay.
Okay, so here we give the 8 and 6. Okay, if we add 8 and
6 8 দেওয়া হয়নি একবার দেখুন a তে 8 দেওয়া হয়নি
সেটাই বলছি ভুল তো এসেছে দেখছি so this is equal to 8 and 6 so 8 is given as a 6 is given as b 8 plus 6 equal to how much 14 and here you see 1 this is equal to 4 so 1 4 14 is there so this is the difference between the bcd adder and the binary adder in case of binary adder 14 should be displayed as 1 1 1 0 but in case of bcd adder the 14 is displayed as 1 then 0 1 0 0 so 4 is displaying here 1 is displaying here okay another number say 9 1 0 0 1 so 9 and say 3 0 0 1 1 and in that case the carry is also 1 so 9 plus 3 plus 1 how much 13 so you see 13 is displaying here this is equal to 1 this is equal to 3 and this is the correction bit to understand these things more properly I have another bcd adder
so why are we deciding the carry
no we are not deciding the carry this is the provision that one is actually the provision for the carry that carry is controlled from the previous stage of adder that carry should not be connected to a toggle switch like this one for understanding this one I just take the carry and we connect it to some toggle switch in case of initial stage we have definitely connected to the ground but this carry is generally connected to the this one okay at the carry out for this second stage got it
yes sir
I have another BCD adder circuit. 1 minute, please. BCD, no, here it is not there. BCD, BCD. That using
BCD adder 7 segment. All gates and niche output of the
car. BCD adder. So here you see, this one is just the extra thing. Here you see, I take the 7447. So just to convert the decimal binary number to the 7 segment, because 7 segment is the most accepted display in the whole world. Because using the 7 segment, the number can be displayed in the decimal number, which can be understood by anybody. From an Astra student to the layman, everybody can understand the decimal digit properly. So that means it's a practice, common practice, that every digital device has a, if it is has a display, then it should not be displayed as digital value, rather the decimal number like this one. So this is actually our output. This is actually our input. Same circuit, only the LED is represented by the BCD 7 segment display. Check this one, say any body number, suppose 6. 6 means 0, 1, 1, 0, 6, and say 8. 1, 8 to 6, so hoye gelo, sale koto bolbo je dhor 9. So 1, 0, 0, 1, so 9. And in that case, carry equal to 0. Initial carry is 0. So 6 plus 9. 6 plus 9 is how much? 15. So you see the 15 is displaying here. So this is called the BCD adder. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very popular question in the mock out. So many years this came. Design a BCD adder circuit. So it doesn't need to design in this complicated format. Just take the 4-bit means what is showing here. Okay, like this one. This is actually the block diagram of the BCD adder. So you just need to add this thing, not this one. This is the student they actually think that this type of thing need to be drawing the exam copy. No, this is a simulation. In the exam copy, everything should be shown by the block diagram like this one. Okay. So this is our BCD number. Any BCD number, if you give any BCD number, it will be at eta koto holo 1. Sorry, 0, 1, 0, 0. Oh, sorry, that means equal to 4. So 9 plus 4 equal to 13. 13 plus carry, if we give the carry, if it become 14. So you see, we can give maximum 9 here. 0, 1, 0, 1. And here also 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. So 9 plus 9 equal to 19. So you see, maximum output is 19. Because we can't give more than 9. That is not ethical. BCD number A, B, C, B, binary number, BCD number. So BCD number should be within 9. We cannot give any other value like this one. So you see, if you give more than 9, it's not a become a BCD number. So garbage will come in actually. So restriction is that A, B should be more within 9. Then carry according to your choice here. Generally, carry is not controlled by you. Carry is controlled by the previous stage of adder. But here, the carry is according to your control. So give within 9 and you show in the display device, you will definitely show the proper value in the decimal format.
স্যার 9 এর বেশি দিয়ে ফেললে ভুল করে কোনো জলে ফলে যাওয়ার কোনো ব্যাপার নেই তো খালি গার্ড
বলবে না পূর্বে কেন আরে কোনোদিন পূর্বে না কিন্তু এথিক্যালি বিসিডি নাম্বার বাইনারি কোডে ডেসিমাল ডেসিমাল ডিজিটে সিঙ্গেল ডিজিট 9 এর চেয়ে বেশি দিবি কি করে এথিক্যালি কি এটা হয় নাকি কোন লজিক্যালি তো হবে না না
না ওটাই বলছি ভুল করে
ভুল করে দিলে উচ্চ পূর্বে না ডিসপ্লেতে ভুলভাল ডিসপ্লে আসবে ওই ব্যাকাতারা দাগ আসবে
ওকে স্যার
Okay, so thank you very much for attending the class. Next day, we'll show the, we'll start the parity. Tomorrow, we'll start the parity.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much for attending the class. And anybody else?
Thank you, sir.
Anybody else? Roll number 13, never attended. Roll number 15, roll number 20, roll number 26, roll number 39, 41. What's it?
রোল নাম্বার 12 স্যার
12 তো প্রেজেন্ট আমি যেগুলো বলছি সেগুলো নেই 44 47 এন্ড ল্যাটারাল L6 এরা বাদে বাকি সবাই আছে ওকে চলো এনজয় দ্য ডে হ্যাঁ
স্যার বলছি আমি একটা ছোট মানে একটা আরএফ কমিউনিকেশন নিয়ে তৈরি করেছিলাম মানে
বাকিদের বলছি বাকিরা যারা অলরেডি হয়ে গেছে তারা এবার চলে যেতে পারো হ্যাঁ থ্যাংক ইউ ফর অ্যাটেন্ডিং তারা এবার চলে যাও চুপচাপ আবার কালকে আমাদের দেখা হবে দেখা হবে না শোনা হবে আর কি কথা হ্যাঁ বল এবার
হ্যাঁ বলছি স্যার আমি একটা ছোট ওই আরএফ মডিউল ইউজ করে একটা ছোট মানে কমিউনিকেশন সার্কিট মতো বানিয়েছিলাম
ওই কত 433 মেগাহার্জ
ওই আমি অত স্পেসিফিকেশন জানি না আমি যেটা ইউজ করেছিলাম হচ্ছে এই এনআরএফ এনআরএফ 24 L1 এনআরএফ
24 L1
L01
কি জিনিস দেখেনি একবার 1 মিনিট প্লিজ
হ্যাঁ স্যার ঠিক আছে
NRF
24 24 ওই যে L01 ওই মডিউলটা
মডিউল দেখি একবার ও আচ্ছা আচ্ছা এটা তো একই ব্যাপার ওই তোর 433 মেগাহার্জ এ কাজ করে এটা হুম এবার কি আছে বল
তো স্যার মানে আমি এটা দিয়ে ট্রান্সমিট করছি এবার এটার সাথে একটা মানে মোটর লাগিয়েছি একটা দিকে একটা এন্ডে মানে হুম মোটর এবারে আমি বুঝ মানে মোটরটা যে লাগাবো একটা আরডুইনো ইউজ করে লাগিয়েছি ওটা মোটরটা কত কারেন্ট টানবে আমি বুঝতে পারছি না আর মানে ওটা রেটিং ফেটিং আমি কিছু জানি না মানে ছোট একটা টয় মোটর
আচ্ছা টয় মোটর জেনারেলি 3 ভোল্টে ইউজ হয় 3 ভোল্টে ইউজ হয় এবং কারেন্ট টানে মিলি অ্যাম্পিয়ারে তোর অরডিনো মোটরকে আরামসে ড্রাইভ করতে পারবে 3 ভোল্টে যদি মোটর নিয়ে একদম টয় মোটর তাহলে অরডিনো ড্রাইভ করতে পারবে যদি এর চেয়ে বড় যদি মোটর হয়ে যায় 5 ভোল্টের মোটর তাহলে অরডিনোটা খারাপ হয়ে যাওয়ার চান্স থাকে সেখানে একটা ড্রাইভার ইউজ করতে হয় আমাদের L293 L293D this is called the motor driver so using the motor driver আমাদের মোটরটাকে ড্রাইভ করতে হয় বা যদি একদম ছোট মোটর থাকে জেনারেলি চালানো উচিত না থিওরিটিক্যালি তো কখনোই কোনো ডিজাইনার তোকে অ্যাডভাইসার দেবে না যে মোটর ডাইরেক্টলি কানেক্টেড টু দা মাইক্রো কন্ট্রোলার মোটর অলওয়েজ ড্রাইভ বাই দা ড্রাইভার ড্রাইভার ক্যান বি কন্ট্রোল বাই দা কন্ট্রোলার
স্যার আমি যেটা করেছি সেটা হচ্ছে একটা সার্ভো মোটরকে খুলে ফেলেছিলাম
হুম
তো সার্ভো মোটরটাকে খুলে ফেলে একটা মাঝখানে আরডুইনো দিয়েছি ন্যানো দিয়েছি একটা সার্ভো মোটরটাকে খুলে ফেলে ওই যে মোটরের যে মানে ভিতরের যে সার্কিটরি আছে ওই মোটরটাকে এক্সচেঞ্জ করে আমি একটা অন্য মোটর দিতে চাইছি একটু মানে ধরুন হাই মোটর মানে হাই পাওয়ারের মোটর কিছু দিতে চাইছি মানে ধরুন 5 ভোল্ট বা 12 ভোল্টের কোনো মোটর দিতে চাই
তো মানে তুই তোর কি তোর সার্ভো যে লোডটাকে কন্ট্রোল করছে সেটা তোর ওই ছোট মোটরটা দিয়ে হচ্ছে না বলছিস
না হচ্ছে না ওই জন্যই করতে চাইছি
তাহলে সবচেয়ে বেটার হতে তুই যেটা করতে যাচ্ছিস সেটা অনেক কমপ্লিকেটেড মানে ডিজাইন লেভেলে কাজ হবে পারবি সেটা খুবই ভালো আইডিয়া ছিল যে এটা আমি যদি কন্ট্রোল করতে পারি কিন্তু তুই ওইখানে অন্য মোটর দিলে আইদার তোর প্রপার্টিজে ম্যাচ হবে না বা তুই ওটাকে ঠিক মতো ওখানে মানে কি মেকানিক্যালি ফিট করতে পারবি না সেই জন্য বেটার
হতে মানে একদম র রাখবো মানে ধরুন কেসিং ফেসিং কিছু ইউজ করব
না একদম পুরো যদি ইউজ করিস তাহলে তুই করতে পারবি কিন্তু বেটার কি বলতো যদি করতে পারিস তো খুব ভালো যদি তোর কাছে রিসোর্স থাকে খুব ভালো আদারওয়াইজ গো ফর এ হায়ার এন্ড সার্ভো মোটর সার্ভো মোটরের অনেক কটা ভ্যারিয়েন্ট পাওয়া যায় আমাদের যদি মানে পয়সার অভাব না থাকে তাহলে ওটা কিনে নিয়ে করতে পারিস অথবা যদি মোটর কন্ট্রোল করতে যাস তাহলে কি করতে হবে তোকে ওই ওখানে যদি হায়ার এন্ডের মানে হায়ার টর্কের মোটর লাগা তত টর্ক বেশি লাগবে অ্যাকচুয়ালি যদি হায়ার টর্কের মোটর লাগাতে যাস তাহলে হচ্ছে মোটরটাকে তুই কোন একটা ড্রাইভার দিয়ে কন্ট্রোল করতে হবে
আচ্ছা এবার স্যার যে ড্রাইভারও আছে স্যার ড্রাইভারও কিনেছি কিন্তু ওটা দিয়ে অ্যাকচুয়ালি হচ্ছে না কারণ আমার স্পেসের একটা ইস্যু আছে ওই জন্য আমি মানে ছোট মোটর চাইছি কিন্তু পাওয়ারফুল মোটর চাইছি এবার ওই জন্য মানে যে গি ছোট মোটর হলে কি হচ্ছে গিয়ারটা পাচ্ছি না না ওটা একটা প্রবলেম হচ্ছে
না গিয়ার মোটর তো ওখানে তুই পাবি না এখন তুই ড্রাইভার কি বলি ড্রাইভারের কি স্পেসে প্রবলেম হচ্ছে
না ড্রাই হ্যাঁ ড্রাইভার মানে আমি যে একটা ওই টেকট্রিক্স এর জন্য আমি একটা বট তৈরি করতে যাচ্ছিলাম তো এটার জন্য এত কিছু তো এবারে আমি চাইছিলাম ছোট করব জিনিসটাকে তো ছোট বানাতে পারছি না ব্যাপারটাকে এই এত কিছু ঢুকে
ওটা ভালো সাইট আছে তুই একটা আছে হচ্ছে robu.in robu.in এ গিয়ে
ওখান থেকে কিনেছি ওখান থেকে কিনেছি
ওখান থেকে যদি তুই কিনে থাকিস তাহলে ওখানে তো তুই যদি কোনো সার্ভো মোটরের একটা বেটার ভার্সন দেখ না তুই এত খাটতে গেলে তো জিনিসটা তো অন্য খোলা কেসিং এ জিনিসটা ভালো লাগবে না মানে মেকানিক্যালি তুই যদি জিনিসটা তো স্ট্রাকচারটা ঠিক না হয় তাহলে ওখানে খুলে ফুলে গেলে তো অসুবিধা হবে না সার্ভো মোটর যদি কিনিস তাহলে একটা ভালো সার্ভো মোটর মানে ছোট সাইজে কিন্তু ভালো টর্কে সার্ভো মোটর দিয়ে দেয় ওখানে আর ওখানে টর্ক রেটিং ও দেয়া থাকে
কন্টিনিউয়াস এটা সার্ভোগুলো অনেক দাম বলছে 800 900 টাকা দাম বলছে
কিছু কিন্তু তুই ওখানে তুই তোর তাহলে কন্টিনিউয়াস রোটেশন তো করতেই হবে তোকে কন্টিনিউয়াস না হলে তোর ইউটিউবে দেখবি ভিডিও আছে যে নরমাল সার্ভোকে কি করে কন্টিনিউয়াস করা যায় ভেতরে একটা পার্টস আছে সেটা ভেঙে দিতে হয় তাহলে ওটা কন্টিনিউয়াস রোটেশনে হয়
স্পিড কন্ট্রোলটা হবে না
কোথায় হবে না স্পিড কন্ট্রোল কোথায় করতে পারবি না
যদি ওই ভিতরে ওটা ভেঙে দিলে তো স্পিড কন্ট্রোলটা হবে না মানে পটেনশিওমিটার ওই পার্টটা যদি ভেঙে দিই
হ্যাঁ পটেনশিওমিটার পার্টটা ভেঙে দিই স্পিড কন্ট্রোল হবে স্পিড কন্ট্রোল থেকে তোকে পিডব্লিউএম করতে হবে মানে যেটা যে ডিসিটা দিবি সেই ডিসিটাকে পিডব্লিউএম করে দিবি তাহলে আরামসে স্পিড কন্ট্রোল হবে
ও তাহলেই হবে স্পিড কন্ট্রোল
হ্যাঁ মানে নাথিং বাট এ সার্ভো মোটর কি আলাদা কোনো মোটর নাথিং বাট এডিসি মোটর না সেটাই পটেনশিওমিটার জন্য তো কন্ট্রোল করবে তুই যদি ওই পটেনশিওমিটার ভেঙে দিয়ে তুই প্লেন ডিসি মোটরকে তুই পিডব্লিউএম দিয়ে কন্ট্রোল কর না তোর বাড়িতে কোনো
হ্যালো হ্যালো
হ্যালো স্যার
নেই বেরিয়ে গেছে মনে হচ্ছে এটা নেই
কানেক্ট হয়ে গেল মনে
হচ্ছে এটা আমি বলছি আমি আগের বার L293 দিয়ে আমাদের অ্যাড্রেসও দুখানা পুড়েছে হ্যাঁ
আমার L293 নয় ভাই আমার অনেক বড় দামি ড্রাইভার বড় ড্রাইভার আমার কিনা আছে হাই অ্যাম্পিয়ার
তো শুন বাড়িতে যদি কোনো ডিসি মোটর থাকে তুই ডিসি মোটরকে তুই পিডব্লিউএম দিয়ে কন্ট্রোল করে নে একবার সব জায়গায় ভিডিও পাবি কোডিং ফোডিং সব জায়গায় পাবি তাহলেই তুই বুঝবি যে স্পিড কন্ট্রোল করে বুঝতে পেরেছিস
মানে পিডব্লিউএম বলছেন মানে আপনি আরডুইনো দিয়ে বলছেন
হ্যাঁ
আচ্ছা
BWMD তুই যদি কন্ট্রোল যেভাবে করিস সেইভাবেই তুই তোর বোর্ডটাই কন্ট্রোল করতে পারবি